Learning to dance is really putting yourself out there, isn't it? Not up for ridicule. Just ask Rodney Hyde or Michael Laws. It's the footwork, you see, all those steps to memorise and the fear of getting it all wrong and making a complete fool of yourself. So what if there was a dance that didn't have any rules? It does exist, you know. It was around 80 years ago and it's back in vintage vogue. As Jendy Harper tells us, it don't mean a thing if it ain't got that swing.
When you're in the swing community, you say the word swing and you forget that other people think, I normally say to people, I do swing dancing, and then there's a short pause. And then I say, it's the style of dancing from the 20s, 30s, and 40s. And then they go, oh, okay.
Sharon Blance is hooked on swing. It hangs from her ears. It hangs in her wardrobe, too.
It's hard to believe, but before swing, I never ever wore dresses or skirts or pretty much anything girly. I think it's brought out like 30 odd years of suppressed girliness, and now it's all gone. Boom!
Her passion for the music of a bygone era has spilt over into her daily life.
As long as I'm singing and the world's all right, everything's swinging.
If I'm in the supermarket and there's a song that comes on and it's danceable, I'll kind of start doing little Charleston steps in the aisle.
Influencing the clothes she wears and the car she drives. For Sharon and many others, swing dancing is more than fancy footwork. It's about fashion, about frocks. A swing ball is one big costume party. When the swingers swing, it's hot and it's sweaty.
It's exhausting, and at the end of the night, you look like hell and you're dripping with sweat, but you've had the time of your life. Watched it and I watched about 10 minutes and I was like, where do you sign me up?
Always wanted to come to something like this and just dress up like this, go back to the 30s and just live like we're in that time.
Once you get into that whole scene, you know, the dressing up and the live bands and that, yeah, you get sucked in and that's it.
You gotta go crazy, you gotta go wild, the music's just there pumping and you just enjoy yourself.
Personally, I love the 20s, the late 20s, the whole flapper and the... I am, yeah? No, not a slapper,
Debbie and Jeff James, responsible for the revival of swing in Christchurch. It's happening elsewhere too. Even pop princess Christina Aguilera is on the bandwagon.
It appeals to young people because there's not this set of rules.
Step, bump, step, bump, triple step.
I mean, we teach what you're supposed to do, but then we let people just experiment with it. And, you know, the most important thing is that you are having fun out there.
Step, 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 step.
And when the lesson is over, the wannabe swingers head for a central city bar, which once a week opens its door, its dance floor, to the swingers. The balls may be disco, but the beat is swing and the pace is exhausting.
Well, that's the thing, is you get kind of sweaty and gross, but you know what? It's so much more fun than going to the gym.
I still think Rodney Hyde and Michael Laws might be challenged with that as well. The next big event on the swing dance calendar, the Battle of the Bands, next month at Canterbury University.